One thing I like about these is that they have natural fibers in them, so most of them are like real hair, so they look a little bit more natural. So the first time you get your lashes, just put your thumb right over the... Hello?
Hello, Encore.
It's your fabulously drop-dead gorgeous twin sister, EnKoreMakeup.
Who?
It's me. Boy, it's my evil, wicked twin sister.
I heard that.
What do you want?
Well, I'm having a bit of a dilemma.
Of course you do. What did you catch this time?
Whatever.
What dilemma? Are you in jail again?
No, I'm not in jail. Well, anyway. Well, I'm a showgirl here at the Moulin Rouge in Paris, and I'm about to go on stage. But I need a quickie.
Ew.
No, I need you to teach me how to do three-toned lips, so I can wear it in a number. Oh, and I want glitters too.
Well, what's your favorite color?
Fuchsia.
Oh yeah? Spell it.
I mean pink.
Sadness. Okay, I have a feeling that you have red lipstick on again. So why don't you take all that off, and what we're going to do is we're going to show everyone how to do that three-toned lip. How's that sound?
Fantastic.
Okay, then here we go. B brilli la pa pa ra pi sa ba du lu le ru du bu sa ba du la du li du la di li li la la baby shoo ba doop sha ba dap shoo ba doop dap da dap dee da shoo ba doop sha ba dap shoo ba doop dap da dap dee da. Hey everyone, welcome back. So our first step is to moisturize the lips, and I'm using Laura Mercier's Lip Silk. Now you can use pretty much any lip moisturizers of your choosing, and it's ideal to do this step at least 15 minutes prior to applying your lip products, so that way your lips will get a chance to absorb it. Next, using some concealer, we're going to neutralize the color of our lips, and you can apply this with a brush or you can apply it with your finger. And then we're going to set that with some loose powder using a powder puff and just press that onto the concealer. Now we're going to need to leave that on for a few seconds so that way the concealer will get a chance to absorb the powder for it to set. Now if you're using lip erase, you do not need to do this step. Okay, next, we're going to brush off the excess powder using a powder brush. Now we're ready to line the lips, and I've chosen a nice deep plum color. And this is Plum Lip Liner. And now that the lips is also neutralized, I'm going to reshape it by squaring off the bottom lips a little bit. And as I line it, I'm not going to focus much on, you know, getting a nice sharp crisp edge to the inner part of the lips because that's going to be blended in with another color. But my focus is getting a nice crisp edge to the outer part of the line. So just line the lips and shape it as desired. And the next step I'm going to do is I'm going to thicken the inner corners of the lip line. So that way it'll give a little bit more dimension to the lip design. Just like you see on the screen, I'm thickening the liner towards the inside corners. Now I'm going to do this to both top and bottom lips. Okay, when doing this, just kind of eyeball it out and make sure that both sides are, you know, pretty similar and pretty even. Okay, so once you do that, we're going to apply our second color. And I've chosen a plum rose color, and this is Florabundi from MAC. And I'm going to apply that all over the lips, including covering the lined areas. Now this color is going to complement the Plum lip liner because it also has a little bit of plum in it. Okay, next I'm going to use my lip brush and I'm just going to blend and smooth out the two colors so that way the transition is nice and gradual. So there, so you can see it's kind of darker on the outer rim and it gets lighter towards, you know, the inner part of the lips. So just try to blend and smooth out the areas where the two colors meet. Okay, next we're ready for our third color. Now I've chosen Myth. Now as everybody knows who's familiar with MAC, Myth is actually a nude color. So I'm just going to apply that right in the middle of the pout and then using a lip brush, I'm just going to blend that outwards towards the plum rose color. Now once you blend and smooth this, the nude color is actually going to turn a little bit of a light pink color. I'm going to use the same thing to the upper lip, just right in the middle of the pout, and then blend that outwards. Now the key to multi-tone lips is the gradual transition between the colors. So we're going to focus now on trying to get a nice even transition. So I'm going to use my lip brush and brush the outer color inwards towards the lighter color. And then I'm just going to eyeball and adjust that as needed. Okay, as you see on your screen, you can definitely see the three tones now. You get a lighter pink color right in the middle of the pout, and then it gradually transitions to a rosy plum color. And then, of course, the lip line area is still that deeper plum color. So just clean and straighten as needed. And then we're going to go over that lip line once again to make sure that we have a nice, clean, crisp edge to it. And as you can see, it really makes the lipstick or the lip design pop more, therefore making your lips, you know, pop a lot more. So it's going to be, you know, a little bit more noticeable. So again, the focus is getting a nice, crisp, straight edge to the lip liner. Now you can play with various different color combinations with this look. You can use like a red lip liner and then use kind of like a lighter shade of red or orange perhaps to the lips. And then, you know, you can apply, you know, a lighter shade right in the center of the pout as well and then just blend all that together to achieve that three-tone look. Okay, now we're ready to gloss. I'm using Lustreglass and this is in Petal Pusher. I'm going to apply it right in the center of the pout, press, blend it outwards towards the corners. Press again, and then work on the upper lip, starting from the center, blending that out to the corners, press again. Now we're going to add some fun and sparkles by using Wet n Wild Mega Sparkle in White Icing. And we're just going to apply that with our finger right in the middle of the pout, on the lower and the upper lips. Just covering the light pink color. Just like so. Okay, and now we're doing a final lip lining. This is just really to make sure that the lip gloss is not going to feather and run. And once you finish that, you have completed your three-toned lip look. It's fun, it's flirty, it's sexy. Make sure to check out starsmakeuphaven.com for those hard-to-find rare lipsticks that are no longer available for MAC. Again, that website is starsmakeuphaven.com. Until next time, thanks for joining me, and I'm sure EnKoreMakeup will love this three-toned lip look.